So the third question I have for you is, can you explain the type of rocks that we can expect at Sunshine, specifically in the regions between the main ranges and the front ranges, as well as what can we expect from the local mountains of Goldside and Lookout?
Okay, so the front ranges, the dividing line between the front ranges and the main ranges is can be seen by the fabric of the rocks. You see that off to the east, there are these colors have long linear trends to them. That's part of the front ranges. And the main ranges, it has these more complex undulating shapes to them, and that really refers to the difference in how the rocks are tilted. In the front ranges, they're tilted so that they tend to be steep, but in the main ranges, they're flatter, and that is one of the reasons why we end up with this hot plateau at the Sunshine Meadows, is because the rocks are standing pretty much horizontal. The type of rocks that we can expect in this area, the rocks are quite old. They're dated primarily in the Devonian and in the Cambrian. So we're talking well more than 300 million years, 400 million years to 550 million years old. There are a few rocks that are a little bit younger than that, but by and large, these are what we call Paleozoic rocks. The type of environment that these rocks formed in were very much like what we see off the coast of Florida today or off of Australia, the Great Barrier Reef. These rocks are carbonates, they're limestones and some shales. Typical type of environment that you see on the margin of a continent with warm seas. Some of the rocks further down in the valley are more clastics. They're sandstones and shales, and they're much younger. Up in the ski resort itself, these are platformal carbonates.
Well, it looks pretty interesting to see that like that specific region has so much different variation of rock types. Is it mostly from the thrust faulting at the time?
Yeah, so these, you're right, bring up an interesting point here. These rocks have been carried up from a much deeper depth. And the way that these rocks have come up to surface is through what are called thrust faults. And thrust faults are great big, long, planar surfaces that have a slight inclination to them, and that if we go far enough to the west, we'll see that these rocks have been pushed up these gradual inclines until it gets to the point where we have these old Paleozoic rocks sitting on top of younger rocks. And so the depth that these rocks came from are many kilometers in depth, and it's only through erosion that these rocks are now exposed to the surface.
Interesting. So for those who